Hi, my name's Steve, and this is the IQ Workshop, and in today's video, we're making a wallet with lasers. So this week we had a bit of an issue where my wife almost lost her credit card after it fell out of her phone wallet case. The pockets essentially became loose. So I thought it would be a good opportunity for me to use some scrap leather that I've got from an upholstery manufacturer and my laser cutter to see if I can make her a replacement. So here we're creating a credit card analog so we can model around it and know how big it is in the computer. Next up, we start to draw the geometry of the pockets and extrude those into 3D space. Pro tip: to get greater control over your dimensions, use fixed construction lines and dimension from those to your sketch elements. Here we start to sketch the geometry that will become the inside liner and the backer of the wallet. Pro tip: to save valuable time, only model half of a symmetrical object and then use a mirror function to fill in the other half. The last thing for us to do now is to punch holes around the wallet for the stitches. Once that's done, all we need to do is export each item as a DXF and we're good to start laser cutting. So some of you might be thinking, hey Steve, I don't have a laser cutter, how can I do this? Well, simply, you can just print your DXF files and cut them out by hand using a sharp bladed knife and a cutting mat. I happen to have access to a 40 watt CO2 laser cutter, so that's the tool of choice for me. So that's everything cut out. All that remains for us to do now is to stitch everything together. Fingers crossed, we should have a wallet. So that's it. The leather wallet is done. It's capable of holding 6 cards, and they all face into the center. So it's designed so that when it folds shut, these cards can't accidentally fall out. So hopefully this will be an upgrade to the phone wallet case. There are a few things I would have done differently, such as beveling the edges, but I don't have a beveling tool. And also the burnishing didn't turn out as good as I'd hoped. So I'll have to investigate some burnishing compound. But all in all, I'm really pleased with the result. It's one of the first things I've made in leather, and I'm definitely going to be doing some more. So if you'd like to see more videos like this, please give me a like and a subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. We'll be right back.